What's going on YouTube? My name is Athena, and welcome back to another Rainbow Six Siege map guide today. So, if you guys don't already see, I did an attacking canal on this map. So, if you want to see that, I can leave the info card above you right now, or I can leave it in the comments. So, let's get right into it. So, canal, defense, and attack have been really popular lately, and I think I want to help you guys win a lot more canal. Because I personally did not like the map until I actually started putting time into it and developing game sense on it. So, you may be bad at canal right now, you might not like the map, and that's okay. But I'm telling you right now, if you can make yourself learn how to like every single map in this in Siege, I'm not asking you to, you know, always like enjoy it, but sometimes you just have to deal with it. And so the first opera I want to go as is Maestro. So Maestro and Legion information ops are really important on a canal, especially like traps and all that kind of stuff. So what I usually do in the first time is make the rotate. If not, if there is no Legion, no impact grenade, then I can just use my pistol, right? So you're asking, should you use your impacts or not? I recommend do not run impacts on Maestro. I forgot to take it off, but use your barbed wire on Maestro. Maestro is super good just because he has so much utility. He has barbed wire, he has a rotation pistol, he has a great gun, and he has two bulletproof cams and barbed wire, all that kind of stuff. So I recommend putting barbed wire right here. Put it right there, not right here, just because, you know, by the time they're already here, they already have a lot of control. So I recommend putting it right here. First piece of barbed wire right there, and then your second piece of barbed wire will go down green stairs, but you punch this, you put a master cam in here, so you can see 90 hallway, and if anyone wants to take it out, they can. But yeah, this is really good information for seeing if anyone comes up the stairs early round, goes in from a kill box, gives away a lot of position. So then you can put a barbed wire, put it about halfway right here. That way it's not too easy for them to punch, but not too much where they get a, you know, get angles onto you. So put it halfway right there and listen for the sound cue. Get those two reinforced walls. You don't really need to reinforce these two walls right here. You don't need to bother. If anything, open them up, because reinforcing them is really pointless. If you want, you can reinforce that wall. Make sure 100% these walls are reinforced. And so your other last Maestro cam will go right here. You can get really creative with it, honestly. You can, if you wanted to, you can like maybe vault toss up of this and then probably get it, you know, somewhere around like something like this, right? So get maybe like right here, or even I like to put mine like on top of here most of the time if I don't have much time to set up. This one is good because if they open up the breach, you can see if they people running the breach, if you see some sky bridge. So you have eye. So where you're going to be playing is right here. So Echo is also use the same setup that you did for Echo, that you do for Echo with Maestro if he's not banned. Echo is really good because he's an ACOG. He can hold pixel on this angle, get really easy kills. It's just in general, Echo is really strong in this one. So you put your Echo drone like right here, and then put the other one right above where the Maestro cam is if you ever do him. So what you're doing in this round, so the time's going down, right? You're on cams immediately when the round starts. You're making sure nobody crouch walks up the stairs. You can hear barbed wire right here and here. Your teammate shouldn't really be anywhere near kill box if he's trying to peek out, because that's just, you're gonna get picked off early on. So you always want to call out. You have the call to call out if anyone is skybridge or sneaking up the stairs. Like, we call it to your team, call out in game. It does not matter. Some people might not respond to you. You might have good callouts, but some people might need to hear that. They just won't respond to you. It's just how solo queuing is and all that kind of stuff. So late game, you want to sit on this a lot, but don't be under cams too long because you may get droned out, and it's possible you can get wall banged from here. People might swing in from the breach. So always keep updated on your positioning based on where the enemies are attacking from. If they're attacking like skybridge heavy, you might want to sit behind a bulletproof thing. If they're pushing the wall heavy, then you may want to sit right here if nobody's over pushing that way, and get ready to swing. Remember, whenever it's a 2v2, you want to try to avoid being on cams as much as you can. Have your teammates watch your cams and all that kind of stuff. So Maestro and Echo are really, really powerful on this site. So if you want to like listen to a lot of this kind of stuff, you can use it with other operators and all that kind of stuff. So we're going to move down to downstairs, which is basically the same kind of lineup. You can either use, I think you guys get the idea of Maestro, but I wanna choose Legion, because I think Legion is very, very important, because people can crouch walk, they can sneak up on you, all that kind of stuff. So I'm gonna choose Legion with impacts, because you're gonna be making one rotate. You can use a bulletproof if you want, if your other team, if your team is running any of those kind of stuff. So if you do happen to run it, a bulletproof cam, put it down in the hallway over there. But most of the time running impacts. So impact this at the beginning. We don't know what walls are reinforced. Reinforce these two walls. Reinforce this wall. Two scuba. It's personal preference if you guys want to open up, an angle up top by here. Because if you open up the top, like head level, you can sit on the stairs and you can see if anybody runs in scuba, so that's also a thing. So always leave these two walls like soft, unless your team wants to reinforce it. But otherwise, why Legion is so good on the site, because you know, he can give away anyone's position if they step into it. So a lot of things you'll do on this site, you can get caught off guard really, really easily, just because there's so many angles for the attackers you can get surprise you from. So what I like to do early on, a tip for Legion, is to always put your Legion mines furthest away from the objective, or the hardest, the most contested places first, because in the beginning you aren't being contested by anybody, so you can go up here safely without getting killed by anybody while everyone's on their drone. You put this up here, because putting that late round, there could already be someone there, and while you're pulling this out, someone would be shooting you down, you know? So I like to put mine about halfway down the stairs. That way, if anyone tried to crouch walk down the stairs, they're going to get hit by a Legion mine. Then it gives us enough to sound cue for them to back off, take it out, and then we have the angle on them. Same as well as scuba window. Even little stuff like this where you have to expose yourself by throwing a Legion mine, that might be the safest spot. So I usually like to put my hardest Legion mines in the beginning. And then while I'm roaming around in sight, I can build up my Legions. So I would treat Legion as same thing as smoke. Because smoke, if you die off with Legions in your pocket, that means you lose the utility of that info. So I like to put mine my Legion mines not too far away from side, because if they're too far away, like all the way up here, there's no point, because attackers can swing there safely, and there's no, you know, we can hear if they're walking down. But Legion mines are like really good for stopping enemies in their rush. That way gives you the sound cue that, all right, you need to watch this part now, right? So where you're going to be playing, around kayaks, scuba, and this area right here. So I usually start out staying in scuba right here, just in case if someone does come down the stairs, I can put pressure here and be the easiest one to start at the first line of defense, you know? So once that, and then depends where they're pushing it, they're not putting any pressure from scuba, you can leave scuba alone, because you already know you have Legion mines here and under the window. So only thing you have to be worried about is people swinging in from the hallway. If you're, do not sit in this hallway like this, because you're going to get swung on by an ACOG or somebody. They're going to catch you off guard, and you're not going to win that gunfight most of the time. So what you're going to be doing, if they are pushing trench in the hatch or most of the time, leave your Legion mines over there and stay here. Because once you're here, then you can you can basically refrag anybody that swings out here. If any swings in trench, you can, you know, kill them pretty easily. But do not hold like any, don't expose yourself too much. Make sure you're always behind cover unless you're gonna swing out. Because also people can also come through here. So a good Legion mine is also like this right here, and then you can guard that. You can rotate a scuba if you need to. So basically these three rooms, you want to use these three rooms as your anchor spots if you don't know where to go. So sit right here. Don't be wide swinging on anybody. Even if they hit the Legion mine, let them hit the Legion mine, because they're already scared enough, and you're gonna make the gunfight more advantageous for the attackers if they're ready for you. So remember, do not peek out late. Only peek if you have to, if you need to regain numbers, or if you need to get more if you know, it's, you gotta be mindful about your peeking, because if you die, no matter what, your Legion mines are always more important. So I know I ran a pick because I was too busy talking, but so basically you can choose any operator you want on this one. I recommend using like Valkyrie, Legion, Mozzie, any kind of like utility op where you can play off knowing where an enemy's position is. Castle is even good for this one as well. So reinforce these two walls. It really depends to your team if you want to reinforce this, but Some people think cafeteria is like a bomb site for some reason. I always see some people making rotates in the cafeteria and they're not even playing it. So it really, you want to make it as less like lines of sight for the attackers as you can for this one, because people can already go from above. This whole wall, this whole ceiling is soft. You can open up the hatches, window. The only place you want to make a rotate is this wall right here. Left or right, it really does not matter as long as you can get from point A to point B. Always make sure the hatches are reinforced. There's a total of three hatches, I believe. Yeah, hatch right here, hatch right there, and hatch in cafeteria. So it's up to your team if you want. Depends on how you're holding it. If you want to open the hatch, so I even need to drop down and retake the site. But the site's already easy enough to retake, and most of the time, it just comes down to the frag. Nobody ever plants in this area, in this rooms, because there's so, it's just so much easier for you to get exposed when you're planting. So your main objective in this one is to try and contest upstairs, but if you're getting pushed out upstairs pretty heavily, then just leave it. There's no point of trying to hold upstairs if you are, if you know you're outnumbered and you're not, you're in a really bad position. If you're right here, if you're sitting right here, you think you're wasting time, right? They're pushing your door, they're pushing your outside windows like these, and you're sitting right here. This is a really bad position to stay in. Unless you have some sort of backup, like if you're sitting in this room, is even bad as well, because people can pinch you from this door, they can watch you from the sky bridge, they can watch your windows. It's just really, really hard to defend up here by yourself. So if you need to ever need to back down, if you're getting droned out and you hear multiple enemies, just leave site, give them upstairs, and just come back to site and maybe lurk around down here instead. Be careful of these stairs, people come from the doorway, all this kind of stuff. But your main job is to try and quote-unquote outfrag the team. They're going to be going above you 100% of the time. If they don't, then the other team is not very good. But if they don't do any vertical gameplay, if you're, let's say you're sitting in sight, right, and they're attacking above you at this point, if they're doing it pretty early on in the round, it might be good for your team to commit to peek those holes. The reason you want to peek those holes is because you want to, the holes are just as advantageous for them as it is for you, because then you get to see where they're going. Basically, you just need to tag them up and kind of like be a spike under their feet. That way they kind of have to either rotate on the stairs or drop the hatches. So watch the hatch drops, because some people will drop the hatch pretty early on in the game if they choose to. But don't be afraid to hold your ground. Just because there's a hole above you does not mean you need to keep repositioning and running around, because that just makes it easier for the attackers to get more holes above you and find your position easier. So the best thing is, once they get like maybe like three holes total, you might want to start picking the holes and hold an angle on them, because you just gotta believe in yourself that you will hit that shot. It's really not that hard to kill the enemies above you. You just gotta spray them down, and they'll scramble as well. And that's how you kind of waste time as well. So like I said, hold upstairs as long as you can. Disengage when you can. When you're able to, but that's a good call for you to save your life, because the more people you have, the easier it is to defend any other site. So that's my tips for defending Canal. If this did help you guys, please leave a like on the video and subscribe if you have not for daily Rainbow Six content. So I'm currently doing a 7-day progression of holographic only. I stream my progress every single day on Twitch for about, you know, average about 8 hours a day, 4 hours in the morning, 4 hours at night. So try to get you guys flexible schedules. So I appreciate you guys for watching this. If you guys don't know how to attack this place, then please watch that video I did upload a few months ago. You can watch that. I'll put the link in the description and the comment. So appreciate you guys for watching today, and don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, and Twitch. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. My mission, tell the day my time is finished. Get my bros, my publishing, don't care about my percentage. Thank God I ain't got no baby mama between my fitted. If I come inside, she got a king inside her belly. You dream gon' take my cup for yours, cause mine is deadly. I was patiently waiting for my time, but now I'm ready. Talk to me nicely, or don't talk to me at all.